Apasasara. Srasrajas to create. Apasasara. What do you mean by apasasara? Create wrongly or make it by mistake. Sangachati.
Gachanti.
Gachanti. Samgachatvam samvadatvam. Have you heard?
Gachanti.
Gama. Avanamati. What is namati?
Prostrating.
Prostrating. What is avanamati?
Not prostrating.
Not respecting.
Disrespecting.
Yes. Okay. Now, nis, I did not get that word. I will just check it. I missed it out.
Nishanga.
Yes?
Nishanga.
Shanga again. I don't know whether it's a dhatu or not. It comes with sound. See, that's why pradhikaram and upasarga, don't confuse. All these words which I am using is with the dhatu, means the verb. Okay, today's exercise is going on to be on this. I want you people to understand a clear distinction between upasarga and pradhiganam. Today's discussion is only on upasargam. Tomorrow I will take you the noun endings also similarly. Okay. Nirnayati. Deciding. Nirnaya panjangam we tell. One which we have taken to do it. Dus and dur is not that much used. Okay. It is used with kr dhatu. Duskritam. Duskaranam. So, dus, dur, the usage is very less. One of the dhatu which I remember is kr.
Dur swapnam is there.
But that is not upasargam. Swapnam is again noun.
Okay.
Please, that is a confusion I want to clear in today's and tomorrow's session.
Okay.
That is pradhiganam. Now, dus, dur, viyojayati. All of you know what is viyojayati?
Disconnecting.
Yes, disconnecting. Yojayati, viyojayati. Agachati.
Coming.
Yes, go, opposite of go. A means opposite. Vasati, nivasati.
Not resides.
Yes, adhikeralam. Yes, in this case, it's a special usage. Adhikeralam, residing in Kerala. That is the meaning of adhikeralam. Atishyete. What is atishyete? One who sleeps over.
Exaggerating.
Yes, excess of sleeping. Okay, so I missed out. Maybe I will give you the word tomorrow. I missed out to add it there. Uddharati is what? Again, here please be careful. Some place they are using Udha and some place they are using Udha also. Dakaram as well as Karam.
To lifting.
Yes.
Uplifting.
Vedan Uddharate Jagannivahate. Has anybody heard this?
No.
It is there in Gita Govindam of Jayadeva. I don't remember the exact where it is. Vedhan Uddharate Jagannivahate is the usage by Jayadeva in Gita Govindam. Hope all of you know Gita Govindam. At least heard about the name. Then Abhipatati. What is Abhipatati? Okay, Gita Govindam is a music work by Jayadeva, which is called, just like Ashtadhyayi, it is called Ashtapadi. It is called Jayadeva's Gita Govindam or Ashtapadi. I will explain Varun offline. Now, Abhipatati.
Going up. It's opposite of falling down.
It can be, it have multiple meanings. It can mean a great fall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall.
Oh, okay.
So we can tell Abhipatati means great fall.
Okay.
Gacha Pratyagacha. What do you mean by Pratyagacha?
Coming back.
Come back. You go there. If nobody is there, please come back.
Yes.
Okay, or your some messenger goes for some work, he is there and says, sir, wo idhar nahi hai. Wow, ghar mein koi nahi hai, office mein koi nahi hai.
So, return.
Pratyagacha. Tvam pratyagacha. Parivrajayati. What do you mean by parivrajayati?
Moving around.
Moving around, correct.
Yes, from this word only, sannyasis are called parivrajakacharya. Now understand how the word has come. Okay, now. Okay, somebody is talking about stock market great fall. Okay, now. Now, so parivrajakacharya is coming from there. Then the 22nd is upadishati. Upadesham, upadishati, giving direction. So these are the 22 upasargas usage. And our homework is going to be based on this only, and that too only from the Moola Ramayana. Is this clear?
Okay.
Sir, what is atishete?
Oversleeping.
Nivasati? Nivasati?
Nivasati is staying. Nivasam.
Staying.
It can see, meaning may change slightly, meaning may not change, or meaning may change totally. In Nivasati, there is no much change. Nivasati, okay. Nivasati, not much change. Now we will go back to the earlier slide and check the meanings. Once again, we will check the meanings going back to the lower, earlier slide. So because if you are able to link these words with the meaning, then it will come. Okay, now, so let us look at the meanings one by one quickly. Then maybe you have to read it 2-3 times. That is why I'm putting in slide share. Is anybody using slide share? Has anybody gone back and read the slide share yesterday or gave for yesterday?
Yes.
Okay, good. Those who do not want to listen to the full video, maybe you want to see one or two parts and clarification, this slide share will be very useful. Do you think it is useful?
Yes,
very much.
Okay. Yes, it is useful.
Okay, so we will continue with slide share. So you'll have to do up, down, look at the slide share and then take a call. Again, when I'm talking about upasarga, whatever I've given here is only one because there is no much space in this. So there are multiple meanings it can come into. Some of them have got one, some of them can be contextual. So based on the context, we have to understand. Here, I'm only put what it is one simple thing. So I will not, otherwise I take 1 hour and only discussing upasarga. So pra is intensity, para is opposite, apa wrong, sama together, anu after, anugachati we saw behind, ava below, avatar, avatarayati, avataram, krishna avataram, all that comes from ava, nis without much, whole entire, dus, dur. Okay, what is dur? How many of you know what is dukkham and sukham?
All we know.
I know.
What is the meaning of that? What do you mean by sukham and dukkham?
Happiness and sorrow.
How does happiness the word come from Sanskrit? How does the word come from Sanskrit? You have to understand the derivation. Come.
Okay.
Yes, I am coming to that only. So it is not an upasarga, but still I am using at the context. It is not an upasarga.
Su is good.
It is feeling. Kam means feeling. Dur, that visarga, refam becomes visarga. Kam, bad feeling. Su is the 17th pradiganam. Su kam, feeling. So sukham and dukkham, we take it as good and bad. Actually, it is good feeling and bad feeling. That is how the word is arrived at. Then we have seen separation. Reverse. Agachati, we have seen. Nivasati, intensity.
Intensity.
Yes, is one of the usages. Adi, in the. Then 15, we have seen it is Veda. 16, Adi, beyond, excessive. Su is good, ut is lift, abhi great, prati return, pratyupakarartam, yattu pratyupakarartam, phalam uddishya vyapunaha, diyajeta parikleshtaya, taddanam, rajasam smritam. Anybody has heard?
17th chapter.
This? Huh?
17th chapter, Bhagavad Gita.
Yes, very good. Yes, very good. So pratyupakarartham, pratyupakaram karoti. Pati all around and upa is near. Clear? Now if you want, just have a look at it to internalize it. I will not talk. All of you can just read through it for two or three minutes so that you internalize it. Only listening is not enough. You also need to internalize it. So I'll give you 2 minutes for each one of you to just internalize it. Now, can anybody based on this identify any of the upasargas used in our Moola Ramayana, whatever we read so far? That is the purpose of internalization. Everybody don't tell everything. One person talk about only one. Otherwise, I will run short of words for today's exercise.
Anujagama.
Anujagama. Very good. Over. Manubandhi, you can talk. Next. So many we have been reading. Any other word? 35 slokas we have learnt. Try to recollect at least one. Banamadi cannot speak now. Banamadi cannot speak. Who else? Who is this? Everybody has got only one chance.
Pariprajyam.
Pariprajyam.
First one. Rajay.
Pariprajyam, which is the
first sloka.
Paripapracha.
Paripapracha. Sorry.
Okay.
Paripracha.
Yes? Okay, fine. So I think we will proceed. So this will be available for you. So when you are doing your exercise also, you can use this as your reference. I will try to fill up the remaining words which I missed out in this and then only upload it. Some of the things as I was doing the exercise, I missed it out. So shall we proceed with the remaining slokas?
Yes.
We go to the remaining slokas. Sa jagama vanam viro ramaprada prasadakaha. Very simple. Saha jagama visarga lopam. Vanam monuswaraha makarasya anuswaram. Viro. In visargasya okaraha rama pada prasadakaha. So viraha rama pada prasadakaha saha vanam jagama. Again I put 2 asterisks there in your Kanpur site, that visarga is missing and vanam they have written with anuswara. So this you have to remember. 1 minute, somebody is So the brave Bharata who conquered envy and hatred went into the forest in order to worship Rama's feet. This is perhaps one of the very simple of the slokas. There is nothing. Saha vanam jagama. Saha viraha vanam jagama. Saha rampada prasadakaha viraha vanam jagama. This is all referring to Bharata. So this is a small error. That is what I put the asterisks there. In the earlier sloka also we saw one small error there. So that just correct. Naichata we saw there. Anybody is using it usefully, the Kanpur site for reference? Okay, now we come to the last one for the day. Okay, good. Gatvatu sumahatmanam ramam satyaparakramam ayachata bhrataram ramam arya bhava puraskritaha. Tameva Raja Dharmatnya Iti Ramam Vacha Abravid. So in the first sloka, Sumahatmanam Ramam. There is no other word. So Gatva. Again Tvantam. Gatva, Pitva, Uktva, Patitva. Then Ayachat Brataram. Again, Samyogaha or Hal Sandhi. What is this? Takarasya Dakaram. Is this Samyoga, Hal Sandhi or Ach Sandhi? What is this? Nobody is,
Hal Sandhi. Hal Sandhi.
It is Hal Sandhi. Correct. We discussed in day 2 or day 3. Okay. Ayachad Bhataram. Again, Monuswaraha. Ramam Arya Bhava Puraskritam. There it is. Ramam is again, it is Samyogaha. Arya Bhava Puraskritaha. So then Tvam Eva Raja Dharmatnya Iti Ramam Vachaha Abravit. So Ramam Abravit. Bharataha Arya Bhava Puraskritaha Bharataha Ramam Abravit. So what did he tell? Arya Bhava Puraskritaha Sumahatmanam Satya Parakramam Gatva Ramam Bhrataram Ramam Ayachat Dharmatnyaha Tvam Eva Raja Iti Ramam Vachaha Abravit. So the first part is for Bharata. Bharata, having gone to Rama, most venerable, etc., spoke to Rama thus, you are the king. Ramam Abravit. What did he tell? Tvam Eva Raja Iti. So two parts. One is Bharata spoke. What did Bharata speak? That you are the king. Now I may just digress a bit from this and take you back to the Ramayana. Ramayana is also referred to as Dharma Shastra. I think some lawyers are also there in this group. I've got doctors, I've got lawyers, etc. So from a legal perspective also, if you look at it, there are a lot of things here. Now the Bharata and Rama Samvadam, Bharata is telling, yes, I have got the kingdom, now I give it to you. Now you accept. Now if you look at Dharma Shastra, Rama is a Kshatriya. And what is Kshatriya Dharma? Shatat Trayate Iti Kshatriya. The Dharma of Kshatriya is Dadyat Na Pratigrhaniyat. Have you heard these words? Dadyat Na Pratigrhaniyat. Now again we go to Pradiganam, Upasargam and all whatever discussed. Kshatriya's Dharma is always to give, never to accept. It is only Brahmana can accept. Rama is a Kshatriya. So from his Kshatriya Dharma, he cannot accept. That is why he has not accepted, says the Dharma Shastra. Again, those who are interested to read more about it, there is a book called Dharma Kutam. I don't know whether anybody has heard about this. There is a beautiful book. It is published by some publisher in Trichy. It is called Dharma Kutam. So in that book of Dharma Kutam, he has taken each of the points of Dharma Shastra and highlighted Ramayana. Just like we discussed about the commentaries. So if anybody wants to do advanced reading of Dharma Kutam, they can do it. So this is clear. This is very simple. So Bharata spoke to Rama telling that you are the king. That's it. The meaning of summary from this part. Now we will go to the homework. Before that, I got few points to tell. So somebody had asked me, can we download the IIT Kanpur link? So those people who have got computers at home, they can do a right click and then say print. And when you print it, you can convert it into PDF. You cannot have any straight away download option. This is for the benefit of everybody, I'm sharing it. Anybody has tried to do this? So suppose internet is not there, we want to read, we want to refer. You can convert this into print form and store it. Okay? This is some query one of the participants had asked yesterday. Then certain points to be noted is, please understand this link which we are joining in daily is expiring today. So tomorrow onwards, the meeting ID is going to change and this is going to remain the same for the next 14 days. I will send you a link tomorrow. As usual, by 3 o'clock, I send the link. When I am sending the link, I will send this link for tomorrow. So please be careful. Don't start using the old link and then tell I am not able to log in. This is the most important thing you have to remember. From tomorrow onwards, the link is changing. So those who have got Gmail IDs, I would urge you to subscribe to YouTube so that the moment my videos are published, you will come to know. You need not wait for my mail to come. So I saw more than 60% of the people are having Gmail IDs. You have to log in and then only subscribe. And also, I want people to comment on the videos. Why I'm telling you is, there is something called a search engine optimizer. So somebody also wants to study Moola Ramayana tomorrow. If this video has to come on top, it also depends on the number of comments given, number of subscribers, etc. So a lot of people have sent me a lot of comments on WhatsApp. If you can do it on that, it will benefit the Sanskrit lovers. That is the idea behind it. Now, I have seen a lot of users logging in with generic name, Oppo 367 and all. I want you to please wait for some time, because I am also taking a daily report. In that daily report, I am seeing a lot of people, Redmi, Redmi MVW, Redmi Pro 5, Oppo. So these people whose names are showing like that, will have to please hang on after the session. I will rename you. So at the end of the day, I know how many people have attended from what time to what time, etc. Okay, now we come to the today's homework. So questions will be asked based on upasarga only. Again, this 15 or 20, 22 words are going to be the question based on, is going to be on based on this 22 words. Any queries? Now I can take for another 2-3 minutes. Any questions? You want, just raise your hand, then I'll unmute you and then you can speak. Because there are more than 60 participants. Anybody wants to, yes, 1 minute. Galaxy M40, please tell your name.
And then, yeah, it's Anil.
Anil Chiplunkar.
Yes.
1 minute, let me just rename you. 1 minute.
Yeah.
Just a second,
but you will see two logins.
I'll just rename you there itself.
No problem.
Yes, done. Tell me, Anil.
Yeah. Can we discuss the difference between the number 1 and number 13? Because both are as intensity. So one is pro and one is knee.
Ah.
Okay. What is the difference? When to use that?
Okay. One will be in the degree of intensity. Okay. Both can be Nivasam, but the context may be different. Nivasati. Now, okay, he has raised a very interesting point. It is not necessary that when using upasarga, you can use only one upasarga at a time.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? I can tell pra Nivasati also.
Okay.
Okay, here but I don't
how,
see
how to identify when to use pro and when to use ni. Are there any specific rules for that?
No, context, as I said, on the context only. You
okay.
Okay, next, anybody? Anil, can I unmute Anil?
Yeah.
Okay, who else? Next is Avinash.
Sir.
Yes, tell me.
Meaning of apasasara.
Which one?
Apasasara.
Apasasara.
Meaning.
Meaning. Wrong creation. Srijati is creation. Srija means create. Apasasara means created wrongly. Okay. If you go to the Bhagavatam, when the creation was done, the bad also was created by God. So when it's a bad creation, it means apasasara.
Okay.
Now, anybody else? I'm not seeing any more hands. Okay, Avinash Kamath, 1 minute. Avinash Kamath, speak.
No, nothing.
Okay. So I'll lower your hand. Anybody else?
I am Ashanai. I understood yes. That Ubasarga is when Pratigana is fixed.
Name, Bharamati.
Bharamati.
Yes, tell me. Yeah, Bharamati
here.
Yes, tell me, Bharamati.
Yeah. See, upasarga is when pratiganam is prefixed to dhaturupam.
Yes.
So is there any, what is the name for when pratiganam is prefixed to noun?
I am still searching. Maybe give me 2 days.
Okay.
I haven't got it.
Okay, fine. Yeah.
Okay. Yes, apashabda. Harish, what is it? No, Gurunath Rao, upasarga in Hindi means they use both together for this verb as well as noun. They, whatever we do, pra, if I add it before this one, and if I use pra before a noun, I will use pra before a verb also, it is called upasarga. Both are called upasargas. That is the answer I can give to Gurunath Rao. Harish ji, your question on apashabda. Can you speak?
Sasara, apasasara.
Loud, I cannot hear you.
Shabda, apashabda.
Yes?
Now, can you hear me?
No.
This is sasara, apasasara.
Yes. Yes. So now, what's the question?
That is what I wanted to see.
No, sasara is a dhatu rupam which refers to srija. Srijati sasara. Created. Appa,
okay.
Created wrongly. By mistake.
Hello. Okay. Hello.
Anybody else?
I'm Vinay Patak here. Hello.
Yes, Varun.
Hello.
Yes,
Vinayak. Vinayak here, Vinayak.
What's your full name?
Vinayak Patak.
1 minute, Vinay Patak. I'll just, this is showing as Vibe P1, right?
Yeah.
Just a second. Okay, I'll just rename.